street because there's some smart parking meters.
Yeah. A lot of people tweeting about this morning. Hey, here's my question for you, Manolo. I heard the mayor earlier.
Okay,
if a lot of these zones are 2-hour or 1-hour parking zones, but if you can do this by phone, so are those 1 and 2-hour zones now, not going to happen?
8 hours?
Yeah, can they turn into 4
no,
hours?
No, those aren't going to change. If it's 1-hour limit and 2-hour limits, it's still going to stay. I think that's one thing they wanted to stress, is that the rules aren't going to change as far as being able to park there.
Okay.
And so you need to move your car.
The price isn't going to change either. So, well, actually, we have Wayne Yoshioka here. Maybe he can explain a lot of that, the City Transportation Services Director. John was asking a valid point. You know, if it's a two-hour limit on that particular area, and you know, you could add by more time by phone, you're not going to be able to once you reach that maximum, I guess.
Well, again, right now the way it works is that if it's a 2-hour meter, it won't let you pay beyond the 2 hours when you actually put the time in.
Okay.
Now, technically, you're supposed to move your car after the 2-hour duration.
Okay.
So hopefully you'll do that.
But can they get by that, meaning if they call in for extra time, can they do it after the 2 hours, or if you reach the maximum?
Well, actually, if the way the meter is working right now, you could actually add time, although you're supposed to move your car after 2 hours.
Aha! We found a loophole. Okay. Well, let's talk about how that's done. We've explained earlier how, you know, you could use coins, and now you can use credit or debit cards. In order to add time, what do people need to know? They have to make sure they know these numbers that are on the parking meter itself.
That's right, Manolo. If they want to use the pay-by-phone option, what they need to do is remember, of course, the number, the phone number they have to call for that. And then, of course, you need to know your zone and your space number. So just jot that down so that when the operator asks you what those information is, you'll have that for you.
And one of the things, too, is in an added convenience, at some point there will be an app or of some sort where you can look at your phone and say, okay, there's an open stall here.
Right. In fact, if you look at the pavement here, there's a little dot that's a sensor.
Those are the sensors over
right
there.
And the sensor actually determines whether a vehicle is there or not. And so, again, that same sensor can tell you or can give us the ability to display on an app where the available spaces are. So that way, people can tell before they go look for a space where the open spaces are. Of course, you don't want to do this while you're driving.
No, you want to do
it. You want to pull over, turn your car off,
yeah,
and look at your app, but then at least you don't have to cruise around and around looking for a space.
And the other side of that is this gives you makes it easier for the city to enforce those people who are at a stall that's not being paid, meaning because not only are there flashing red lights in the back of this if the meter's expired, but you have an actual, a monitor that can tell you, point you out, okay, all these meters are expired.
That's right. You know, one of the things right now that's inefficient is our enforcement crew has to go out and actually go and patrol and look for the violations. Right now, they'll know where the violations are. They can go directly to the violation and cite that violation.
One last thing, Wayne, probably another concern is when you use something where you use your credit card, a concern about the data, is it being stored in here? Meaning, I don't know, if somebody decides to steal a parking meter, God forbid, is that a concern about being able to steal their identity theft?
Right. No information is stored on the meter, so no one can actually open the meter and try to pull information from there. And also, this is a direct read. In other words, a card has to be inserted and swiped. So it's not like one of those tap visas where you could just put near field and just tap it like that. You have to actually insert the card. And so, you know, you've heard some places where people have been hijacking people's tap visas because they have to have a reader and they just go nearby and they can read it.
Right.
This is not that type of visa. This is a swipe visa, so it actually has to make contact.
Okay. Good to know. Okay, so once again, starting today, right around, we are on Punchbowl and King and around the Civic Center area, you have the new meters, and then in about 2 to 4 weeks, it'll cover Chinatown and downtown.
That's right. Once we're making sure everything's working properly, we'll expand this phase one to downtown and Chinatown, and then we'll go into a 6-month trial period. And at the end of that 6-month trial period, if everything's kosher, we'll expand it to the rest of the island.
Thank you very much, Wayne. Wake Up Today, we'll be right back right after this.